Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and we will be talking about the piriformis muscle and how it can help us organize some of the neurovasculature in the deep posterior hip region. Specifically, we are talking about the piriformis muscle after it's exited the greater sciatic foramen on its way to the greater trochanter. So that greater sciatic foramen is an important component here as well. So there is quite a bit of structures exiting the greater sciatic foramen that had originated in the pelvis, and so we're going to talk through some of these. There will be multiple branches of the sacral plexus, as you can see here coming out from these anterior sacral foramina. And these branches will exit the greater sciatic foramen in order to reach specific regions of the lower limb. As the sacral plexus is the prominent supply for the lower limb other than the anterior medial thigh. Additionally, some branches of the internal iliac artery will also exit the greater sciatic foramen. The majority of the branches of the internal iliac will supply pelvic viscera, but there are gluteal arteries that are branches of the internal iliac as well. Let's see, here we go, superior gluteal and the inferior gluteal. So you have all this neurovasculature traversing this area. So here's that greater sciatic notch with the ligaments. It'll be the greater sciatic foramen. It would be right around this region here. So you have all this neurovascular traversing the region. In addition, you will have a muscle, which is your piriformis muscle. It will traverse the greater sciatic foramen, and its distal tendon will insert on the greater trochanter of the femur. And having a muscle belly here, so having that to be able to distinguish from the neurovasculature, can really help serve as an important landmark on getting organized in this region and being able to differentiate between the neurovasculature. So oftentimes you hear this referred to as the key to the hip. And you will certainly hear me refer to it as the key to the hip. When I am dissecting this area, I always try to locate the piriformis first, and that helps organize me for the next step. So if you're looking here, here is the piriformis muscle belly. And then you can see the tendon heading towards the greater trochanter right here. All right, so in the greater sciatic notch would be right around this region here. Any of the neurovasculature that you can see coming out or visible superior to the piriformis is the superior gluteal or gluteal neurovasculature. So any of this right here are branches of that superior gluteal neurovasculature. Now take a moment and think, what does the superior gluteal neurovasculature supply? What does it innervate? The gluteus medius and minimus. So this is going to be important in terms of those muscles. There is considerably more neurovasculature located inferior to the piriformis muscle, more than we will discuss here, but there are three major things I want to note. The first one, or major one, is the sciatic nerve. And this whole thing right here is the sciatic nerve. It is an impressive nerve. I always enjoy watching students locate the sciatic nerve in dissection, as it is so impressive, as you would expect the biggest nerve in the body to be. But you can see it exiting and descending inferior to the piriformis muscle. Right next to it right here, you can see the inferior gluteal neurovasculature will also exit inferior to the piriformis and travel as a unit. Typically, if you're in this type of dissection, as you see here, it's been cut because the gluteus maximus has been reflected, and in this case, it's actually been removed. So it makes sense that this would be cut because that's what's supplying the gluteus maximus. Additionally, and not visible in this image, will be the pudendal nerve and internal pudendal artery, which also exits the greater sciatic foramen inferior to the piriformis before almost immediately recurring backwards towards the pelvis to innervate the perineum. All right, excellent. We have reached the summary slide, and hopefully you are convinced as to why the piriformis muscle is the key to the hip and the basic pattern of neurovasculature organization around the piriformis. Thank you for your time and attention, and have a great rest of your day.